to avoid the whammy as they play the most exciting game of their lives. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. And now here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter Tamarkin.
Thank you. Thank you, Rod, and welcome everyone to Press Your Luck, where we're talking about some mighty big dollars. So let's meet the three players who are going to be vying for those dollars on Press Your Luck, starting with Julia Huskins. How are you, Julia?
Fine. How are you, Peter?
Good, thanks. Julia, where are you from?
Well, I'm from Austin. I'm currently going to school in Austin, so I'll say I'm from Austin.
All right, that sounds good. Now, you said you went to, you graduated of Northwestern University.
Right. It's the school with the record for the longest number of losses in football, 34.
Oh, well, that's good for Northwestern. you're gonna break that spell here, and you're going to win, right?
Right.
All right. Good luck to you, Julia. Nice
Thank
to have you with us. Let's meet John Raber.
How are you, John?
And, John, you're a student?
Yes, I am.
I see. And
I'm a grad student of business at USC. But I don't see much of recurring game shows. So.
I see. USC, huh, John?
Yeah.
Does it bother you that I went to UCLA, John?
Well, I went there as an undergrad.
Okay. You're okay, John. You're okay. You speak four languages?
Yes, I do.
I can see one of them's English.
And I speak French and Italian and Spanish.
Well, the whammy speaks a different language, so hopefully you can communicate with him and keep him away from you,
let's
all right?
Hope so.
Good luck to you, John.
Thanks.
And let's talk to our returning champion, Peter Geldmacher, with $12,896. Peter, you want to make some more money here?
Definitely, Peter.
Yeah. You discussed this whole situation with your family?
Yeah, they don't believe it. They'll see soon, though.
They'll see it. Okay. Players, I have four questions. Your correct answers will earn you spins of the big Press Your Luck game board. A correct buzz and answer gives you three spins. A correct multiple choice gives you one spin. And the more spins you have, well, it's quite obvious, the more money you can win, because that board up there has a whole lot of dollars and a whole lot of prizes. And every time you stop the board like this, stop! What happened? $750. I'm back in the chips. I'm up and down like a yo-yo. It's $750. You don't want to hit a whammy. He takes away all your money, and that's a real depressing situation. All right, players, are you ready for your first question?
Ready.
Here we go. According to a recent poll, what fraction of Americans made a New Year's resolution to lose weight in 1984? Julia.
One half.
In 1984, Julia says one half. Is the correct answer one half, one quarter, or three quarters? John?
I'll say one quarter.
One quarter, says John. Peter?
I think there's a lot of hefty people out there, Peter, so I'll say a half.
A half. Well, half of all Americans resolved to lose weight this year. Julia picks up three spins, John not yet, and Peter picks up a spin. Here we go. Someone likes you, John. Here's a Press Your Luck wedding hint. According to Ann Landers, these days, what's the minimum amount of money a clergyman should receive for performing a wedding? Julia?
$200.
All right, is the correct answer $200, $25, or $100? John?
I'll say $100.
John says it's $100. Peter?
That sounds like a good figure, $100.
$100. Well, the minimum a clergyman should receive for tying the knot is $100. All right, that means John picks up a spin and Peter picks up a spin. Julia, you're going to have a lot of clergymen calling you. You're generous. All right, third question. Connecticut has the nation's first lemon law. What consumer product? Peter?
Automobiles.
Does the lemon law deal with? Peter says it's automobiles. Is the correct answer automobiles, fruit, or microwave ovens? Julia?
It's automobiles.
Automobiles. John?
I concur, automobiles.
Automobiles. The lemon law deals with automobiles. Julia goes to four, John to two, and Peter to five. And we go to our fourth and final question. Almost all of us have our personal favorite, but for the country at large, what is the most popular spectator sport in the United States, Julia?
Football.
Football is the correct answer. Football, baseball, or horse racing? John?
I'll say baseball.
Baseball, says John. Peter?
Horse racing.
Horse racing. Well, you can bet our most popular spectator sport is horse racing. Julia stays at 4, John stays at 2, and Peter goes to 6. Well, that was the last question, so you'll all have a chance to convert those spins into mighty big dollars. So stay where you are. We'll be right back right after this. Round $1, and I know you're dying for this part of the game. We have $13,000 in cash up there in our famous board. We have some surprises, and we have a few whammies, so be careful. The player who ends this round with the most money gets to play last in the final round, and as they've probably seen by watching the game, that's the place to be, because you have an advantage in that position. Now remember, you can pass your remaining spins at any time during your turn if you don't want to be hit with a whammy, and of course, four whammies put you out of the game, which is a bad place to be, all right? We're going to go to the player with the fewest spins. That is John. Player John goes first. Are you ready with two spins and $0?
Okay, all right. Come on. Let's get some $10. Stop.
Stop at $750.
All right.
750. One spin left, John.
Come on. Keep it going. Keep it going. Stop.
Stop at $750 again.
All right.
A nice round, $1,500 for you, John. Well done. We go to Julia with $0, but she has four spins.
Okay.
Julia, here we go.
Let's go. Big bucks. Come on. Stop.
Stop at
all.
Julia, at least he apologized, but you have three spins left, one whammy, $0. What's your pleasure?
I'm gone.
Here we go.
Okay, come on, big box. No more whammies. Stop.
Stop and advance two spaces to $750.
Okay, I'll take it. Great.
Everyone's in a rut. 750. Two spins left, Julia.
I'm going.
Gotta go.
Stop.
Stop at a bedroom set.
Great.
Value of that bedroom set is $719. That brings you up to $1469. That's $31 less than John.
I'm going.
Gotta go.
I'm going.
One spin left.
Stop.
Stop at a whammy. Blew your $14.69 away. Two whammies, $0. We're now going to go to Peter with six spins. Are you ready, Peter?
All right, let's go. Big box, big box. Stop.
Stop at a whammy. Whammy has run amok. Five spins left, Peter.
Gotta go, Peter.
Okay.
All right, let's go. Big box, big box, big box. Stop.
Stop at $250. Second place, four spins left, $250.
Gotta go. All right, big box, big box. Stop.
Stop and advance two spaces to $750. You now have $1,000, $500 less than John, three spins left.
Gotta get ahead of him.
Okay. Well, we're going for first place.
Big box, stop.
Stop at $200. You're at $1,200. You have two spins left. Press your luck or pass, Peter.
Gotta go.
Gonna go again. $1,200 on the line.
Big box, big box. Stop.
Stop at $300 now. Peter, you have $1,500, ties you with John for the lead. One spin left, you're gonna go. Peter wants that first place. Okay.
All right, big bucks, big bucks. No whammy. Stop.
Stop at $750. $2,250, you did it, Peter. You have first place and you have the advantage. John has $1,500. Julia has $0. We will be right back with a whole new set of questions and some more goodies. So come on back. In this round, the price of spins is increased dramatically. In this round, a spin can be worth as much as $500. And to get those spins, you answer questions, and you know what these are, right? Questions. All right, remember, the player who ends this round with the most money gets to take it home and come back again next time. Are you ready? Here we go. What winter month is America's least favorite month? John?
January.
Least favorite month to get married in? Is it January, as John said, February, or December, Julia?
February.
February, says Julia. Let's go to Peter.
I'm going to have to guess December because of the holidays, Peter.
December. Well, America's least favorite month to marry is January. John picks up three spins. John, you're obviously clairvoyant. Buzzed in early and got lucky. Okay, second question. Mickey Rooney, Artie Shaw, and Frank Sinatra will all marry to the same woman. At different times, of course. Name this much married lady. John?
Zsa Zsa Gabor.
All right, is the correct answer Zsa Zsa Gabor, Ava Gardner, or Rhonda Fleming? Julia?
Ava Gardner.
Julia says it's Ava. Peter?
I'll say Ava Gardner.
Ava Gardner. The lady whose married names have been Rooney, Shaw, and Sinatra is Ava Gardner. Julia picks up a spin. John stays at three, and Peter picks up a spin. And here we go with our third question. The busy lady. According to a Gallup poll, what French delicacy is considered by Americans as the least appealing thing to eat? Julia?
Escargot.
Escargot. All right. Is the correct answer escargot, brains, or liver? John?
I'd say brains.
Okay. John says brains. Peter?
I think I'll have to agree with escargot.
Escargot. Well, that unappealing French delicacy is snails or escargot. That means Julia picks up, goes to four, John goes to, stays at three, and Peter goes to two. As far as I'm concerned, you can have them all. You know, they're all liver and brains. Okay, here we go. If you're one of the tourists visiting Washington, D.C. in the spring, you'll see 650 cherry trees blooming. What country sent us these cherry trees? John?
Japan.
All right. Is the correct answer Japan, France, or the Philippines? Julia?
The Philippines.
Philippines, yes, Julia. Let's go to Peter.
For some reason, Peter, I think it's France. I don't know why, though.
France. Well, those D.C. cherry trees were presented to us by the mayor of Tokyo, Japan. Julia stays at four, John goes to a big six, and Peter stays at two. All right, that was the last question. That means our players will be taking those spins to the big board. Decide who's going to walk away with all the money right after this, so come on back. It's that time. You know what time it is. It's time for Big Bucks. 50,000 Big Bucks up there on that board. In fact, there's one prize worth more than $5,000. However, just to keep you kind of honest, I know you wouldn't want it any other way. We have some whammies up there as well, you know? So be careful. Let's take a look at your dollar totals. We have Julie with $0, John with $1,500, and the champ, Peter, with $2,250. That means you have the advantage. You're going to play last, and this is the final round. So contemplate what your plan is strategically while we go and deal with the player with the least amount of money. Julia, $0 with four big spins. Julia,
come on,
two
no
whammies.
Way. Stop
at $2,500. You're now in first place, Julia, by $250, three spins left.
I'm going.
You're
going
to go.
Okay, no whammies. Stop.
Stop at Big Bucks. $5,000 and a spin. $7,500 for you, Julia.
I'm going to
go. Three spins, she's going.
No whammies, no
$75 on the line.
Stop
at $4,000 and a spin. Julia, you're now up to $11,500. That's $9,250 more than Peter. Three spins left, two Emmys. What's your pleasure?
I want a little bit more cushion. I'm
you want
go.
A little bit more cushion?
A
okay,
more.
Julia. That's,
okay, no
let's
whammies.
Hope you get it.
No whammies. Stop!
$2,000. Julia, $13,500. Over $10,000 more than Peter. Two spins left, two Emmys. What's your pleasure?
I will pass to Peter.
They will be passed, and they go to Peter. The two spins go to you, Peter. You can contemplate them for a while. We're going to go to John with $1,500 and six spins. You got some catching up to do, John.
Sure
$12,000 worth.
I want some
here we go.
Stop.
Stop it at Freeport, right. The Bahamas. A trip valued at $2,125. That brings you to $3,625. Are you ready, John? Five
keep
spins
it
left.
Going.
You're second place. Here we go.
No whammy. Stop.
Stop at a whammy. He didn't forget the money, John. $0, one whammy, but you have four spins.
Plenty of time.
All right.
Big bucks. Stop.
Stop at $750.
Okay.
Third place, $750. Three spins left, John. What's your pleasure?
Roll on.
Here we go.
Stop.
Stop at $1,500. Tied with Peter with $2,250. Two spins left, John.
Gotta continue.
Gonna go on.
Come on.
$2,250. Looking for big bucks.
Big bucks. Stop.
Stop at $2,500. You now have $4,750 and second place with one spin left, John. You have about $9,000 less than Julia.
I'll continue.
Gonna go. John's going 47-50, looking for $8.
Stop.
Stop it already. Better duck, John.
Double rats.
Double rats. $0, two whammies, no more spins, but the game's not over, John. We're going to go to Peter with 22-50. Two spins, Peter, that you have to take one at a time. Here they come. 22-50 against 13,005.
Big bucks.
Big bucks. Washington, D.C. is what you get, Peter. A trip to Washington, D.C. worth $1,916. You're now at 41.66, 9,000 less than Julia.
Okay,
one more
Peter.
Spin you have to take.
Big bucks, big bucks, big bucks. Stop.
Stop at $1,500. You're now at 56.66, about 8,000 less than Julia. Now you have two spins you can either take or pass. Ah, Peter passes
Julia.
The spins to Julia. Strategic move on Peter's part. Hoping that she whammies. Julia, two spins you have to take. If you avoid the whammy, you can stay in this game and become champ.
No whammy, stop!
$500. Julia, you have $14,000. You have one more spin you have to take. If you can avert the whammy, you'll be the champion for today. If you whammy, Peter stays as the champion. Peter, are you ready? Julia, you ready? Here we go.
Stop!
Stop! $500! And Julia with $14,500 is the champion for today. Congratulations, Julia. We'll be right back to find out exactly what you won right after this message. Today's big Press Your Luck winner, Julia, with $14,500. Julia!
Great!
And I've got even better news for you, Julie. It is all in cold cash.
Oh, my God!
$14,500. Now, Julia, I expect now maybe Northwestern will even start winning. What do you think? You have broken the spell.
Well, they've won this year.
Well, then you've won too.
Oh, gosh,
so it followed hand in hand. Congratulations, Julia.
Thank you.
Good amount of money. Well done.
Thank you.
Peter, you played it strategically correctly, but Julia had the cards. You are not leaving with a sad face. You're leaving with $12,896.
No complaints, Peter. Super. Wonderful time.
You were great. Thanks for being with us. Thanks for being a great champ, Peter. John, double rats.
You, deal.
It's the way it plays sometime, but you're not going to be leaving empty-handed. We've got some nice prizes for you. I thank you for being with us, and all three of you gave us a great game. It's terrific. I thank you very much. Before we leave, we had a little note from Joanne Moore of Belfast, Maine. Now, Joanne, you know, we ask people to send in little ditties about the whammy so that we can read them on the air. Some of them are incredibly creative. Some aren't. In any event, this one's very good, so I think I'll read it to you. Are you ready, class? Everyone ready for this one? All right. The whammy can make you feel oh so ill, but he'll leave no money to pay the doctor bill. Is that a fact?
That's for sure.
Well, until next time when we see Peter, this is Peter Tamarkin saying so long for Press Your Luck. Bye-bye. For you. This is Peter Tamarkin saying so long for Press Your Luck. Bye-bye.